before we get started into the Onyx Blood Red Wine Smoky Eye, we have to make sure that your base is completely flawless. So I'm gonna get my Real Techniques foundation. Wow, it's been a while, eh? I'm gonna get my Real Techniques foundation brush and a cream foundation. And I'm just gonna buff this into the skin all over. Next step after the foundation, I'm going to use a concealer. I'm doing light taps, even though it looks like I'm beating my eyeball up. It's actually very gentle. As we know, after the foundation and concealer, we have to set all of this with powder or else it's just gonna move all over the place. Okay, so after the base is done, we are going to contour with a neutral powder and a blush brush. So we're gonna contour a bit of the cheekbones, jawbone. Just gonna do a little bit of the nose. I do have a tutorial that explains how to contour more in depth if you're interested. After the contouring is done, we are going to use a little bit of bronzer to marry in a bit of the sculpting into the foundation. Also, it just makes the red wine smoky eye look a little bit more sexy. I just realized today, okay, this is a Guerlain Four Seasons bronzer. It costs over $50, actually more than that. But I just realized I've had this for almost 2 years now and I've only gone through half of it. If you divide that amount into the amount of times you've used it and the quality that you get, and if you're a bronzer freak like me, it's definitely worth the investment. So 1, 2, 3, blend, blend, blend. Next step are the eyebrows. So I'm gonna be using a wax first, and this is by Benefit. And I also have a separate eyebrow tutorial as well that you should check out because it will change your life. And the next step I'm going to do is I'm going to fill it in with the powder, and I am going to use the applicators that it comes with because they're decent. But you can also use an angle brush as well if you prefer. Now onto the eyes. I'm going to use a chocolate brown eye kohl, and I'm going to trace in the inner waterline of my eye and also the top bit. And this might tickle for some of you, even for myself. So lightly lift up your lashes to help push your waterline forward. This should be a very delicate process. I don't want to see anyone doing this. Even though it's on YouTube, I know many of you are very guilty of pulling your eyes. Same pencil. And lightly just smudge this along the lash line. So I'm going to use my finger. Just smudge this in. It does set to be a bit water resistant, so you do have to smudge it in a bit quick. So after that's done, clean it off. Next step, I'm going to use a matte red eyeshadow. I know it's a little tricky to find a matte red eyeshadow, but really just find a red blush before you get all excited and start slapping that eyeshadow on. Have you ever heard about being a tissue ninja? What you want to do is get a piece of tissue, place it under your eyes, please. This is going to protect the bottom bit from getting the red eyeshadow, because we all know once we get the red bit in there, you're gonna look like you got punched in the face. I'm gonna get my blending brush, my matte red eyeshadow, while keeping this here, the tissue. Make sure it's nice and flat. I pat it over. So I'm applying a bit of the black eyeshadow actually, and a dark brown in the outer bits, and just a little bit, just a hint of it in the inner part of the eye. I want to keep the center a bit bright because it's going to pull the eyes out. One thing you'll notice about me, I'm very minimal with brush use. I'll use very little brushes as possible. I am going to use another brush now. This is an angled one from SHU UEMURA. I'm using a light vanilla powder. The last bit of the eyeshadow I'm going to use is actually this new makeup brand I just discovered. It's been around for a while. It's called Kiko. It's based out of Italy in Milan, and it's amazing, and the price point is freaking awesome. The next step I'm going to do, I'm going to use my finger again. I'm going to get a little bit of this shimmery champagne-y eyeshadow. I'm just going to dab it into the inner corner. That's it. Just easy peasy. I'm also going to get a little bit of it and just smudge it into the center of my eye. It doesn't have to be perfect. We are trying to mimic illusion of reflection. Since I'm already highlighting the inner corners, I'm going to use my finger again, lightly apply it on the cupid's bow, just to give it a little bit of a pattier look, because it slightly lifts, gives the illusion it lifts your lip a little bit. It almost looks like you're about to kiss whoever you're talking to. So now that we have the eyes done, we're gonna curl the lashes. And for the mascara, I'm actually gonna be using a black brown one. I'm gonna do the bottom bits first. I'm just gonna coat the top of my top lashes and the bottom of my top lashes. And then I'm going to get a little bit of blush. I'm gonna make the blush like a very sheer peachy color, pinky peach. Last step would be lipstick. I'm using peach stock. I'm gonna get, I know this is really naughty, but I already have a chocolate brown pencil. This is eyeliner. I'm gonna lightly just dab it in the outer corner. I'm just gonna wedge it. Because we just want a little bit of contour on the lips. That's alright, no one knows that it was an eyeliner. And then a bit of gloss. And this one is like a milky plummy nude, which I like. I didn't want to match the gloss exactly to the lipstick or else I would have looked super washed out. And there we have it, we are done.